Across North Harbor Drive, from the City and County Administration Building, and west of downtown, is San Diego's Embarcadero. It's where you can buy tickets for sightseeing the city and San Diego's Bay, as well as enjoy restaurants and sights along the waterfront. The Old Town Trolley Tour has a stop right in front of the Maritime Museum. In 1948, the Maritime Museum was established, and it has the distinction of restoring, maintaining, and operating historic vessels. The museum features the Star of India, the oldest active sailing ship in the entire world. She was built in 1863 on the Isle of Man with the name Euterpe, one of the muses in Greek mythology for music and lyric poetry. She survived a collision, a mutiny, a cyclone in the Bay of Bengal, and the death of one of her captains, who was buried at sea. The Euterpe circumnavigated the globe 21 times, transporting emigrants to New Zealand and Australia, and served as a cargo ship to India. In 1901, the Euterpe was purchased by the Alaska Packers Association, known for their star fleet of ships. The Euterpe was renamed the Star of India. She made 22 salmon runs between Alaska and San Francisco before she was retired in 1923. 3 years later, the Star of India was acquired by the Zoological Society of San Diego. After the Great Depression and World War II, her restoration began in the late 1950s. In 1976, the Star of India set sail once again. She has sailed several times since. Just behind the Star of India is the HMS Surprise. It was originally built in 1970 as a replica of an 18th century ship called the HMS Rose. The Rose suppressed smuggling and served in the Continental Navy, precursor to the modern US Navy. In 2001, the replica was purchased by 20th Century Fox and converted to represent the HMS Surprise, a Corvette-class ship with 24 cannons. This replica was used in both Pirates of the Caribbean and Master and Commander movie series. The 1898 steam ferry Berkeley served in San Francisco for 60 years and also functions as the museum's offices and store. Next to the Berkeley is the USS Dolphin, which is the deepest diving submarine in the world, at almost 3,000 feet. She set this record in November 1968, and a year later, the Dolphin launched a torpedo from the deepest depth recorded. Behind is the San Salvador replica, the first European ship to sail along Southern California, and the Californian, the official tall ship of the state. You can see many condominiums and hotels situated next to North San Diego Bay. Restaurants like the Brigantine have prime location on the waterfront. All the businesses along the pier have attractive architecture. Here's an interesting dome structure at The Catch. Throughout the boardwalk, you'll see 22 of these tiled benches. They have artwork celebrating the Big Bay, painted by the Children's Museum of San Diego. Artwork entitled Bird's Words conceals a bathroom. Artist Pei White took the words from the novel Jonathan Livingston Seagull. The Port of San Diego and the B Street Pier have everything needed to dock cruise ships right here on the Embarcadero. Wide open shipping berths accommodate for the largest of cruise ships. Disney, Holland, and Norwegian are some of the cruise lines that depart for destinations like the Panama Canal, Mexico, Hawaii, and Vancouver, Canada. On the B Street Pier itself is a large clock in the form of a ship's helm to help passengers board on time. This telescoping forklift, or genie telehandler, is essential for loading or unloading the cruise ships that come into port. He has left the B Street Pier, going to the slightly smaller Broadway Pier, just to the south. The Broadway Pier also handles cruise ships and has the Port Pavilion at the end with scenic views of the bay. The Port Pavilion can be reserved for special occasions and corporate events. On the south side of the Broadway Pier, you'll see the boats of flagship cruises. They have harbor cruises that sail to the opening of San Diego Bay at Point Loma, as well as underneath the Coronado Bridge. Here's a flagship cruise coming back in now. It's the Spirit of San Diego floating slowly by the Broadway Pier. Welcome aboard. The USS Midway Museum is literally the biggest attraction at the Embarcadero. She was commissioned 8 days after the end of World War II in 1945 and served in the US Navy for 47 years. The USS Midway was the largest ship in the world until 1955 and was the first aircraft carrier too big to fit through the Panama Canal. She operated with the Atlantic Fleet out of Norfolk, Virginia, and served in the Vietnam War and the Persian Gulf in Operation Desert Storm. She went through two major deck plan modernizations in 1957 and 1970. Her flight deck became angled for landings, and her edge elevators were moved, adding an additional aft elevator. Each elevator had its load capacity almost doubled to 110,000 pounds. Notice the cabling wrapped around the giant pulleys. They bear the weight of each of the 70 aircraft the Midway carries. In Operation Frequent Wind, the Midway was sent to the waters of South Vietnam with a mission to evacuate American personnel and South Vietnamese before Saigon's capture by the North. Many Huey helicopters piloted by South Vietnamese were crowding the flight deck, guided only through hand signals from the flight crew. On April 29, 1975, a small civilian Cessna 01 began circling over the Midway with its landing lights on. Unable to communicate by radio, the pilot dropped two notes onto the flight deck, which quickly blew away in the wind. A third note was a pistol wrapped with a message. It read, "Can you move these helicopter to the other side? I can land on your runway. I can fly 1 hour more. We have enough time to move. Please rescue me, Major Buong, wife, and 5 child. Captain Chambers knew many of the helicopters were low on fuel and could not take off. He ordered all available personnel to push overboard 4 Hueys and 1 Chinook. Totaling $10 million at the time. All arresting cables were cleared, as the small plane had fixed landing gear and no arresting hook. Major Buong Lee set the Cessna down on the flight deck, bounced once, and rolled to a stop with 200 feet to spare. His wife emerged holding a baby, and the Major and his children were greeted by the ecstatic crew. The USS Midway Museum is one of the many Navy ships that homeport in San Diego. When you look across the bay, you may see another, like this LSD, or dock landing ship, heading around Coronado toward the opening of San Diego Bay at Point Loma. Surrounding the Midway are monuments like this one, celebrating the 200th anniversary of the U.S. Navy in 1975. The 250th anniversary is coming up in 2025. Next to it is another honoring those who perished on December 7th, 1941, in the attack on Pearl Harbor on the island of Oahu in Hawaii. This one is a monument for the USS San Diego and her 756 officers and crew. She was an anti-aircraft light cruiser, serving in World War II from 1942 to 1946. She arrived at her Southern California namesake here in May 1942 and set off for Guadalcanal in the South Pacific, where she provided anti-aircraft support for the USS Enterprise. The San Diego never lost a man to enemy action. The floor shows a map of her travels from Guadalcanal to Tokyo Bay and her 18 battle stars earned along the way. Homecoming is a statue by Stanley Bleifeld that's just off the boardwalk near the Midway. It portrays a serviceman who has just returned home. It's a sight we often see in real life here in San Diego. Under the backdrop of a crane in downtown San Diego is the United States Aircraft Carrier Memorial. Carriers changed the tactics used in naval warfare, and this memorial honors them and their personnel. Listed on its sides are fleet carriers, training carriers, light carriers, escort carriers, and amphibious assault ships. Here is a memorial for Taffy 3, comprised of 6 small escort carriers, 3 destroyers, and 4 destroyer escorts. Outgunned and outnumbered, under the command of Vice Admiral Clifton Sprague, they fought off a Japanese fleet of 23 ships, including the super battleship Yamato, in the Battle of Samar on October 25th, 1944. To the south of the USS Midway in Tuna Harbor Park is this group of statues seemingly frozen where they sit or stand. Closer inspection shows they're all members of the military, looking at the individual on the right. This memorial is dedicated to Bob Hope and the military he entertained during the nearly 50 years of USO tours from World War II to the Persian Gulf War. He was an actor and comedian and well liked for his support of the military. As a testament to his popularity, he has hosted the Academy Awards a record 19 times, more than double of anyone else in history. The last statue next to the Midway is adapted from a photograph taken in New York's Times Square on August 14, 1945. The couple stands at a height of 25 feet, and for many decades, their identities remained a mystery. The original photographer took 4 pictures on VJ Day near the end of World War II. It was done in a few seconds. Over the years, several servicemen and nurses claimed to be one of the subjects in the Life magazine photograph. Forensic analysis performed in 2012 points to George Mendonca, a Navy quartermaster, and Greta Zimmer Friedman, a dental assistant. Sometimes things are better left alone, as we all are intrigued by mysteries and enjoy using our imaginations. The San Diego City and County Administration Building is near the Embarcadero. On the east side stands the Guardian of Water. Why was an exact duplicate gifted to Yokohama, Japan? If you have seen the San Diego review of Harbor and Shelter Islands, you know the answer. If you are curious to find out, please search and watch that video after this one. South of the administration building is the Children's Waterfront Park Playground. Children play in the fountains. To cool off on hot days. There are trees that line the walkways and soft padded blue foam around all the slides, merry-go-rounds, jungle gyms, and play areas. There are some picnic tables, however, you must guard your food as the seagulls are ready to dive in when it's unattended. And by the time you return, you'll be pecking at an empty bag, like this seagull. There are other animals that are not as animated, but nonetheless fascinating to observe. This one is made by Nikki de Saint-Fol, a French-American sculptor, painter, filmmaker, and author of hand-illustrated books. What does it look like to you? And why are there holes in its body? It's titled Large Seal and reminds us of the many seals you may see along the La Jolla coast in San Diego. Here's another sculpture by Nikki de Saint-Fol. Does it resemble anyone in particular? On the back of his jersey is the number 19. Most people will walk by and see just a baseball player. Longtime baseball fans or San Diegans will know it's Tony Gwynn, who played his entire 20-year career with the San Diego Padres. He was one of the best batters of all time. His statue has an ideal spot to see the kids enjoying the sun. Nikki de Saint-Fol was a self-taught artist. Her art pieces can be seen throughout San Diego and all over the world. Not only are they in art galleries, but outdoors for everyone to see. Like this serpent tree. Serpents are a theme in Saint-Fol's artwork. She used them for the perfume named after her, as they can be seen intertwined on the face or atop the bottle's cap. Snakes are found in swamps, forests, grasslands, or deserts. This hydra, or many-headed snake, appears to be of the desert, judging by the surroundings. Is that correct? Look closer inside their mouths. What do you see? There's a hint spraying in the background. The colors and reflections off the serpent tree are quite dazzling in the sun. Their tongues are actually spray nozzles to shoot out water. Combined with its vibrant tile skin, the serpent tree was meant to be displayed as part of a fountain. In her final years, Nikki de Saint-Fol moved from Europe to San Diego for health reasons. She wrote, "California has been a rebirth for my soul and an earthquake for my eyes." Many appreciate San Diego as much as she did. If you've enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching San Diego Review.